My platform is breast cancer awareness.
Miss Mohegan Sun Casino.
Tiffany, Greetings, welcome to your host for this evening, Marilyn Gale, and from WFSB Channel 3 Sports, Joe Tessitore.
You know, I cover college basketball for a living.
You are kidding.
Well, yeah, I do this little thing.
Oh, which team do you cover?
Any UConn.
And you, ladies and gentlemen, are not going to believe we got to meet a couple of those UConn players today, or actually just one.
That's right.
We came in this morning for rehearsal. Ricky Moore was here and Jim Calhoun. They were here for some awards presentation. And who do you think was the least poised when she saw them? That would
you.
Be me.
But I'm trying to get down the pageant lingo.
Yeah.
You know, I got the hoop lingo down, but I know we don't have any slam dunks here tonight.
No, we don't have slam dunks.
And we don't have any champions here.
No, we have title holders.
Title holders, no champions.
No champions.
I think I'll make my way through it. But I'll tell you what, this reminds me a little bit of before the Duke-UConn game. I mean, I've been here all day, and it reminds me of that same atmosphere before UConn went out and beat Duke. The anticipation was great. It built up all week long, and then all of a sudden, boom, you got yourself a new title, and that's the same thing that's going to happen here tonight. We got the anticipation, we're building it up, and at the end, we will have a new Miss Connecticut.
It is exactly the same feeling. This weekend is our party to celebrate a new Miss Connecticut, along with the last one chosen in this millennium. She's also the 71st representative going to Atlantic City to the Miss America pageant.
This is our second year here at the Mohegan Sun. There are not enough words to express how wonderful the Mohegan Sun has been to our contestants and the production staff. It's just been a great experience. On behalf of the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Program and our board of directors, thank you to the Mohegan Sun for your support of the program and our 18 local representatives.
You know, when you talk about anticipation, and for these ladies, it hasn't just been this past week. It's been a culmination of a whole year's work of preparation and achievements, and now that famous title and crown is finally in sight. And one young lady, her dream will become a reality in just about 2 hours.
And those dreams, they start off at the local level with the local pageants, and some of the reasons for being in the program were the opportunity to garner scholarships. And for others, it's the chance to have a forum of self-expression. And trust me, you're going to get a lot of that this evening, a lot of self-expression among this group.
Now you're into sports trivia. I'm going to give you a little pageant trivia. The scholarship portion of the Miss America organization was established in 1945 and has grown to the point where the Miss America organization awards over $35 million annually at the local, state, and national levels. It makes it the largest single source of scholarship funds for women in the world today.
Oh, but I've done my homework, and I come with stats. Right here in our state alone, over 193,000 will be made available in cash and tuition scholarships to our contestants. Tonight you'll see the swimsuit, the talent, the evening wear, and on-stage interview competition, which ultimately will decide our next Miss Connecticut. Well, this time we have an important guest to welcome to you, folks. He's the newly elected president and CEO of the Miss America organization in Atlantic City. He's the man who will take the Miss America pageant into the new millennium. I'm proud to introduce Mr. Robert Beck.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Lovely tonight. Thank you. The pleasure is mine and my wife Elizabeth, who's here with me, to join you in your 71st year of celebration. And we are so excited to see the show come together, see these wonderful young women. And, you know, only one can go to Atlantic City. But as the head of the judges panel mentioned earlier today in the session that they had with the parents of the contestants, every single one of them is a winner. They're absolutely wonderful. We're so very pleased to be here tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Great to see you. Thanks for being a part of this evening. Well, she doesn't just look beautiful, she sings beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, Marilyn Gale.
Thank you, Jeff. How many of you like Patsy Cline? Oh, yeah. She's my absolute favorite, and please feel free to sing along.
Mm-hmm.
Is that talent or what?
I didn't know you had it in you.
That is just outstanding. How about it, folks? Before we reveal our 10 semifinalists, congratulations are in order to each of the outstanding young women who have made it all the way here to the finals of the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Pageant. Whether or not their name is called, they can all take pride in their accomplishments, and another accomplished young woman is here to present a Lifetime Achievement Award, Miss Connecticut 1998, Lauren Bergamo.
you very much. I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to meet Lauren. It's my first time to meet Miss Connecticut as the pageant winner and worked with last year. The first time I met her, I know we were very nervous. We communicated, but we did very well. And we taught her signing, and we learned a lot through. And my goal to get this award, for me, no, for everybody, all the deaf-blind people in Connecticut. I really support the deaf-blind people in Connecticut. Also, I want to say thank you for my wonderful family. I wanted to say my mother and father, my brother and sister, please stand up. That's my family. But she's not here tonight. We also have become strong as a deaf and blind person. I want to support other deaf and blind people in Connecticut, also all over the world. We want to improve the services. Reason, because many deaf and blind people can't drive, they can't go to school, they can't go to work and socialize. They need more support to lead, like me, who helps her take out everywhere. To help to understand deaf and blind, what that means. It's not really nothing being isolated. They need to get out more as a normal person. Thank you very much, Lauren, for the award. Thank you, thank you.
the fifth semifinalist. It is contestant number 11, Marissa Perez. Number two, Taylor Chambers. was unbelievable. Great job. How about a big hand for the dancers, folks?
How about a round of applause for all of our contestants?
Great job by everyone. We're all fabulous.
All right, you know, we have a new producer and a new choreographer, and they are responsible for this high-energy production that you see on the stage
they
tonight.
They are simply the best. I understand you're going to talk about the scoring.
I'm going to talk about the scoring.
That reminds me, this is the longest span I think I've ever gone without checking the baseball scores. I've been here since 11 o'clock this morning.
Well, you know what?
Let's run off and just see if the Yankees won.
I'm gonna catch up later.
Okay. I'll see you later, folks.
It's no wonder the Miss America pageant seems to be every woman's dream. To make it a reality, competition began Thursday with the private interviews, which constitutes 30% of the total score. Last night, we saw each contestant compete in swimsuit, which counted for 15%, talent, which counted for 40%, and evening wear for the last 15%. Tonight, we will see our semifinalists compete all over again, with the scoring to change as follows. The interview scores will be carried over from Thursday and count for 30% of the total scoring. Swimsuit and evening wear combined will still count for 15%, and talent tonight will be lowered. Be added in after the top five are announced, and they participate in an on-stage interview with my co-MC, Joe Tessitore, near the end of the show. Before we begin the talent portion of tonight's competition, we'd like to highlight our current Miss Connecticut. One of pop music divas, Cher, made a statement this year by recording a song about time spent after losing a love. The lyrics ask you to look inside and be strong, because there is life after love.
Welcome Lauren Bergamo, as she presents Lily.
Connecticut pageant held a fundraiser called the Miss Sweetheart Pageant. Some of the girls competing tonight have been former Miss Sweethearts. Amongst the esteemed alumni are our Miss Connecticut 1995, Amy Zappone, and Miss Connecticut 1998, Lauren Bergamo. Some of our current sweethearts are with us tonight, and we'd like them to come up to the end of the stage. We have Janae Bolden. She's Miss Connecticut Little Miss. If you can get some light down there.
Thank you.
to surf the net, I have some exciting news to share. Friends and volunteers of the Miss America organization are encouraged to become part of the Miss America Community Hall, an interactive web board where volunteers become family. The Community Hall will give you opportunities to, first of all, meet Miss America organization volunteers from all across the country. You can also establish online friendships with those volunteers. You can even help contestants with their questions, everything from overcoming shyness to finding a particular accompaniment tape. You can take part in games, Miss America trivia contests, and storytelling. You can also listen to others and make your local organization the best it can become. Volunteers can sign up through the Miss America homepage to get authorization to the private local volunteer conference at www.missamerica.org. Thanks. Yeah, applause for that. Tap into the popular song Jump, Jive, and Whale. Miss Quinnipiac, trusted Sue Oliver, has self-choreographed intricate and challenging tap steps with the latest swing moves. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 16, Tressa Sue Oliver.
You sitting there wondering what it's all about. You ain't got
Natalie Cole classic Paper Moon will now be performed by Miss Woolgate, Christine Pelletier. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Christine Pelletier. Right now, a very special treat. The enormous popularity of the Spice Girls has spawned similar successful groups all around the world. This year's Grammys found country music's The Dixie Chicks as Best New Country Artist. And now in 1999, from the country of Ireland, we have a hot new quartet called Bewitched. Ladies and gentlemen, we present Carol Willis and the Miss Connecticut Dancers performing the hot new look of C'est la Vie. And let's not forget to mention our fabulous choreographer, Nefra Sullivan.
Shall we move on with the talent competition?
Yes, we shall.
All right, I'll take it from here. I'd like to announce the remaining five talents, beginning with contestant number six, Sylvia Gomes. From the Academy Award-winning movie, The Piano, Miss Hamden, Sylvia Gomes, will perform The Promise on the piano, composed by Michael Nyman. Ladies and gentlemen, Sylvia Gomes. I wasted about 2 years of piano lessons that my mom forced on me. Well, I don't know where to start with the thanks, but the Miss Connecticut Board of Directors would like to take this time out to thank the Mohegan Sun Casino and their staff for hosting this year's Miss Connecticut Scholarship Program. The outstanding people who have made Mohegan Sun the success it is are helping make Miss Connecticut a shining success in Atlantic City. To the Mohegan Tribal Council, a very special thanks for believing in this program and your warm generosity. Chief Roland Harris, Vice Chairwoman Jane Fawcett, heartfelt thanks go out to you. How about a hand for the Mohegans? The talent competition moves onward, and we move to contestant number nine. It's Heather Currier. Take you along as she dances her way to the big time.
Make a killing, we'll get top billing. I'm gonna make you a star.
Great job there, folks. Okay, contestant number 17 is next up, Kelly Hillman. Join Miss North Haven, Kelly, as she walks along in the style of Natalie Cole, recounts her adventures with an orange-colored sky. Ladies and gentlemen, Kelly Hillman.
Please.
We conclude our talent competition now with contestant number two, Taylor Chambers. It's a song made popular by Cole Wilkinson and most recently by Linda Etter and Miss Long Island Sound. Taylor Chambers will sing the Man of La Mancha, I, Don Quixote. Ladies and gentlemen, Taylor Chambers. This evening for the title of Miss Connecticut, you're about to meet the people who will make the decision. We are proud to introduce our distinguished panel of men and women who will select that young woman who will serve our next state representative to the Miss America pageant. Our first judge is a trial lawyer at her family's Boston law firm. She held the title of Miss Massachusetts in 1987, won the most talented non-finalist award at the Miss America pageant. She was also her state pageant's executive director for 5 years, served as an Eastern Regional Trustee, co-legal counsel to the National Association of Miss America Pageants. She is a cum laude graduate of Suffolk Law School, a summa cum laude graduate of Merrimack, where she's a member of the adjunct faculty teaching paralegal studies. In her spare time, as if there is any, Orally performs regional and community theater. A warm Connecticut welcome to Orally McCarthy. Judge number two was born and raised in New York City. Jim has been an active member of the Miss America organization since 72. He has served on numerous committees and eventually became the executive director of the Miss Staten Island pageant, currently the largest local scholarship program in Miss America's organization. Currently director of field operations for the New York State pageant, supervisor of sales department of ADT Security, serves the board of directors of Project Hospitality and Alzheimer's Association, among other positions. He's received citations from the New York State Governor's Office for his many community and professional achievements around the
Thank you.
edition last year of the two-piece swimsuit option. Well, once again, our contestants have been given the opportunity to choose either a one-piece or a two-piece swimsuit of their own choice in color and style. This particular segment of our show gives the judges an opportunity to see how well the contestant has maintained good physical fitness. The contestants present their look in the swimsuit competition. Scoring will reflect an overall first impression as well as a statement of physical fitness. We begin swimsuit competition for our semifinalists with contestant number 15, Heather Valente. Heather is a senior at the Hart School of Music and the University of Hartford. Her ambition is to become a reporter at the New York Times. Her platform is promoting volunteerism. Thank you, Heather. Contestant number 16, Tressa Oliver. Tressa will be a senior at Bay Path College in the fall. Her ambition is to own, operate, and teach in her own preschool. Thank you.
be one of those people in People magazine. Dining out with the big movie stars, baby, you're gonna dig caviar. Drinking martinis behind the diviner inside a limousine. Hearts in a bash, making a splash in People magazine.
Production production of the local pageants across our state. Earlier today, in a separate ceremony, kind of like the Academy Awards, special awards were presented at the Yankee Doodle Dandies in categories such as Best Opening Number, Best MC, Best Use of Contestants, along with many others. We'd like to thank Pat Toll for designing the awards for this afternoon, and Stacy and Bonnie would both like to present a special award right now.
The Miss Connecticut Scholarship Program proudly presents Pageant of the Year to Miss Greater Watertown.
Around and they
just take the rest of the year off, but...
Hey, they're working hard.
I mean, you know, they're making, they're paying the rent there, folks.
Oh, I see it, I see
there it.
There it is! Woo! Thank you! Thank you, Jeanette. Ladies, we know you're ready. My question is, ladies and gentlemen of the audience, are you ready for the announcement? Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Miss Gregory Williamson. audience out there, we just want to tell everybody something a little bit special about you. Marla skipped out on rehearsal this afternoon, but she had a very good reason. Can you tell everybody why you missed rehearsal this afternoon? I know you're having trouble breathing, but you can spit it out.
Sure, today was my high school graduation. I'm a new alumna from Sacred Heart Academy. Excuse me.
New Haven for their donation of a van to transport the judges. Also, a special thanks to Vinny Petta for being their chauffeur. We'd like to also thank Mary Lynn Karpicki, the accounts manager with Swiss Army Brands. The contestants and the judges received very useful credit card-sized knife sets with the Miss Connecticut logo. Virginia O'Rourke from O'Rourke and Birch Florist in Waterbury and Middlebury donated flowers to our judges and to myself and Joe, so we'd like to thank them.
Wonderful.
And Hot Petunia, we'd like to thank them for the roses provided for each of our contestants. They also were kind enough to provide bouquets for our Miss Connecticut 1998 and Miss Connecticut 1999. Audience is great. Clap right on cue. We'd like to recognize some very fine people in the audience with us this evening. They have given us the chance to share their daughter's talents and friendships. They are the ones responsible for the beautiful array of talents, smarts, beauty, and charm on our stage. Would the parents of our contestants please stand and be recognized? All 18 of the girls are so beautiful inside and out, and it is because of the parents and the love and the dedication that they have given these young ladies for their entire life, so I applaud you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for the one-on-one interview with our top five finalists and Joe Tessitore.
The judges have requested I move the flowers, so can we just recognize the flowers for a quick second?
The flowers are gorgeous.
Flowers are beautiful, aren't they? They're gone.
Hey, Joe!
They can't see the contestants, they say, so I'm just going to, there they go.
I was going to say, I'll take them, and I can say that I got flowers from Joe Tessitore.
I don't know how Rebecca Tessitore would feel about that.
Joe will be interviewing each one of our contestants on a general nature, as well as a question towards their platform. This will constitute the last 10% of our finalist score. Our finalist level of comfort and spontaneity are all taken into consideration in the judging. The Miss America organization wants their state and national winners to be able to promote an issue or need of the community. It's the intention of the Miss America organization to have their representatives become involved as spokespersons and connect with the world around them. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Tessitore and our five finalists.
Thank you very much. This is the moment we've been waiting for, our final competition here. And I've been told that I'm not allowed to ask about zone defenses or the full court press. We're going to start with Marissa. Nice to see you. Congratulations on making the top five.
Thank you.
What I want to know from you is, what has been the best part of this entire experience?
The best part about this entire experience is the friendships that I have made. It's unbelievable to see all the talented contestants that are in this pageant. They're talented, they're intelligent, and they're willing to promote their platforms to the best of their ability, which is very, very important.
They are indeed. Sylvia, you're all so talented. Pass it down the line here. And the talent you guys display is just phenomenal. But how do you focus before you get up there and do your performance? What do you do to focus in before you get up on stage?
Well, my mother gave me a really beautiful, inspirational prayer. And so I read that over a few times. And I also just close my eyes and try to focus on the music and what I look like when I'm going to be up there.
Taylor, the hot pink, looking radiant. Has Miss Connecticut been a learning process? How so?
This has definitely been a learning process for me because I started when I was very young with the Sweetheart Pageant, which is almost like a stepladder to make it up to this event. And so I have learned so much about stage presence, about presenting, and about having a platform and being an advocate of something. I think that's very important.
Hello, Miss Forte.
Hello.
We asked you in rehearsal.
rehearsal, what is your forte? We now know it's making the top five. 5 years from now, how do you see yourself?
Hopefully successful, being a choreographer on Broadway. And basically, I live day by day. I have a plan for today, and hopefully I'll be successful for tomorrow.
Sounds good. Christine Pelletieri, why are you doing this? Why are you here? What made you get to this point?
Well, it's very important for me to get scholarship money to further my education, which is in dancing, and I have a lot of fun doing this.
Wonderful. So we've gotten through the first round so far. Now, Marissa, what I want to know from you is your thoughts on peer pressure to underage drinking.
My thoughts on peer pressure to underage drinking, well, I basically focus on education, and it's unfortunate to see that in educating our youth about alcoholism, it takes education to be started in middle school, and we need to start in the elementary level. I can speak on behalf of my experience. I was taught about alcoholism and its effects in depth in middle school, and that's still too late of an age to start.
If there was one short, quick message you would tell a youngster about that, what would it be?
It would be to stand up for themselves, be confident, and learn a lot of communication skills so that they can express their problems whenever they need to their peers, to their teachers, and that's very, very important. I say that achievement, appreciation are the most important critical ingredients in any child.
Sylvia Gomes. What advice would you give to a student who is feeling that, you know what, there's so much going against me and it's just so hard to survive in this day and age with all the distractions and all the problems that are going on in my life?
Well, I think one of the most important things would be to guide that student also to another student that might have been through the same thing as that student might have been through. You also guidance counselors at school that might be able to help that student. And I tell them about my own life and about all the things that I've overcome to be able to be where I am today, because it hasn't been easy.
The inner city right now of bilingual homes are an issue, and how that plays out in school. What's your advice there?
I think it's very important to be bilingual, and many students actually find it an advantage that to be bilingual, because it just gets them to so many places in life.
Thank you, Sylvia. Taylor, your platform?
My platform is animal rescue and placement.
One of the critics that would say we have so many human problems and issues to deal with, why care about the animals?
Because many people don't think about all the animals do for us. Animals are used for laboratory testing. That is putting advancements in medical research today. Animals are used for C&I. They're used for rescue. They're used for protection. Animals are used for a lot of other things aside from just having a pet around your home.
Thank you very much, Taylor. Chris Ann Forte, what does the word respect mean to you?
The word respect means to me to honor oneself and stand up for what they believe.
What do you respect in life, and who do you respect in life? Who has been your inspiration in your life, or what has been your inspiration?
There's been so many inspirational people in my life, but the one person that's been my inspiration is my friend Cindy. She just at the age of 18 had a mastectomy, and that's my platform, breast cancer awareness. And to see her make it through as a strong person is what I call an inspiration.
Wonderful. Christine, how do you explain drug abuse to kids?
It's when you abuse a certain drug.
How difficult is it when you're dealing with so many negative influences and images to explain drug awareness to children?
It's difficult because they go towards what their friends like, and it's a lot of peer pressure for them, and I try to teach them how to have confidence and raise their self-esteem in themselves.
What do you tell them?
I tell them to believe in themselves, and everyone's a unique individual, and they need to realize that.
Wonderful. How about a folks. Marilyn? Nice job, ladies.
Nice job, ladies, and great job, Joe. These ladies all possess what it takes to become not only a Miss Connecticut, but a Miss America. You might not be aware of it. Yeah, you can applaud that. You may not be aware of the dynamic organization of which our Miss Connecticut program is a part of. The Miss America organization heads 51 state pageants and over 1,400 locals across America. Also, your program book tonight will tell you of the many other grants and awards our winners and runners-up are eligible for. And when our winner goes on to compete in the Miss America pageant in Atlantic City in September, thousands of more dollars in scholarship will be available to her. She can go on to further her education with the many tuition breaks, grants, and free coursework at her fingertips. This year, the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Pageant Board of Directors is pleased to announce that available to Miss Connecticut 1999 and runners-up are scholarships valued at $198,000. These include tuition scholarships from the following schools: the University of New Haven, valued at $71,600, Palmer College of Chiropractic in Davenport, Iowa, for $41,000, the University of Bridgeport at $75,000, and Briarwood College in Southern Bergamo. I'm not going to say much because I really don't like sitting here and listening to girls go on and on about farewells. All I have to say is the song that you will be hearing was written by my voice teacher, Joseph Baginski, and he wrote it for me and gave it to me as a gift before I went to Miss America pageant. And it pretty much says it all. I dedicate this song and every one of you. before that, let's welcome back Sean Sullivan and the contestants for our finale, as he tells them that true beauty comes when you look deep inside and stay the same. Sean and Lauren are going to present our non-finalists with some roses. We'd like to recognize all of our contestants. How about a round of applause? We started with 18. Fabulous contestants.
Great job, everybody. You all look beautiful tonight.
Now, in separate applications, two $1,000 scholarships, one from community service.
Here.
Yeah.
What'd you think of Sean tonight?
Sean. Hey, I
just got a pipes or what?
I have a prediction. Now, we were backstage talking about our case. Would you go out in about, I say give it about 3 months, we're going to be able to buy a CD at this place to start.
I think you're dead on. He's wonderful.
Thanks,
so. Nice job, Sean.
Ladies, let's present some awards. The winner of the Miss America State Community Service Award is Miss Greater Newington, Marla Prince. Congratulations, Marla.
Congrats.
The winner of the Miss America State Academic Award is Miss Quinnipiac, Tressa Sue Oliver.
The winner of the Interview Award is Miss Hamden, Sylvia Gomes.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, we will be announcing the winner, but let's reintroduce our top five finalists, starting with Marissa Perez.
Finalist number two, Sylvia Gomes.
Finalist number three, Taylor Lee Chambers.
Finalist number four, Chris Ann Forte.
And finalist number five, Christine Pelletier.
Yes, indeed.
All right, now the moment we've all been waiting.
I beg of you.
Judges, look at me now.
Please.
Do we have a decision? They're shaking their heads like this. Judges.
She will not only receive scholarships and awards valued at over $120,000, but will also assume the responsibility of being a role model and leader in this state. She has an amazing year waiting in front of her as she travels to Atlantic City in September to compete for Miss America. The first runner-up is a very important place, for if any reason the winner is unable to fulfill her obligations, the first runner-up will assume the title of Miss Connecticut 1999.
Woo, I think we need a major drum roll here. The first runner-up and the winner of a $2,500 scholarship is
Thank you very much.